Hey, so I'm going to be doing the study predicting Huntington's disease, extreme learning machine with missing values. It was published 2018, so this year, by people in the USA. And they started by saying that problems with incomplete data and missing values are common and important in real-world machine learning scenarios, yet often underrepresented in the research field. So basically, they're saying that in research, people don't really account for them very well. That's what they mean by underrepresented. There's need to be a better methods to account for missing values. So here's the scenario. A study was recording exercise and IQ for a few years. Then they decided to add diet and recorded exercise, diet, and IQ. So now it's three variables. Well, after a few years, half of the data set has only two values with diet missing during the first half of the data. What to do? And then, for example, in this poll, you can see that most of the values are missing for this variable education, and only some people answered this question. And then the researchers go on to say that particularly data related to healthcare trends tends to or to healthcare tends to feature missing values, which must be handled properly, and ignoring any incomplete samples is not an acceptable solution. And this is very true, and a lot of people don't realize this, how unacceptable it is. So for example, because sometimes only people who get very sick from test diet may drop out of the study. Those people are then the missing values. If you disregard them, conclusion may be that the diet was good for them, when in fact the missing values are exactly those cases when diet was bad for the person. So you can't disregard the say a value because it's missing, because it may be missing because the person dropped out of the study because it was bad for him actually. He didn't just randomly decide to drop out. And then a lot of data sets look like this. So there is missing value. So if you say disregard this value, well, maybe this person was actually who died from this food, and then you actually shouldn't disregard it because that means that this value is actually super negative. So this paper will talk about the methods to account for this sort of thing. Subscribe to this channel, and I'll make a more videos on this paper, going through it all the way to conclusions and methods and everything.